Alright, what's going on, guys? So, like I said, here training at the Gym Vista today. Want to come and say it's a great gym. If you're in Southern California, please come out, support this gym, come here and train. It's an amazing gym, to say the least. It was part of my prep for the Olympia. The people here are amazing. You got Rachel, you got Todd. They're awesome people, and they'll take care of you at this gym. Got my boy James here.
What's going on?
He's 17 weeks out of the Cal. Like I said previously, you know, big hopeful of mine. I think if he shows up at his best, he's gonna be real dangerous. So follow along with this workout. Our first working set here, Smith Machine Incline Press. Not gonna go too crazy today, but we'll still get some work.
Sir,
come on.
Okay.
What are we here for? Come on. We're gonna stay locked in. Come on. More. Come on. Three. Two.
Come on.
Yes, sir, come on, here. Here, let's go. Win. Hell yeah, man.
Come on.
Three.
Get it. There you go. Control. And again. Strong. Rack it.
Bring that energy.
Let's dog. Go. Oh, sit. Oh, sit.
Come on. Two.
Sit.
Almost there. One more. Come on. Make it work. Yes, sir. All right, guys, so we got the second exercise here, shoulder press. On my second push days, we typically want to do shoulder emphasis, so we'll start off with an incline variation for chest that hits primarily upper chest and that anterior delt head here. And then we'll do our second movement with the primary focus on shoulders to really get that focus and that engagement there right in the beginning of our workout. Really get the most out of the movements. So, yeah, first working set here.
Good control, yes.
More.
Good control, again. Yes. That was it. Up. Close up. Top. Up. One.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. I'm with you. Come on. Three. Come on. Push, 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 push. One more. One more. Dig all the way down there. Yes, sir.
Ah.
Five more with the 110s.
Guys, what's going on? So I kind of got lost in the work there. Was just going through the exercises. What you saw before was flat dumbbell chest press with a slight elevation. It's going to really engage that pec minor, pec major. When you're super flat, you know, just that horizontal plane, you're not going to get that full activation on the pec minor here. So that slight elevation helps you get that primary activation across the board on your chest. Now we're on our fourth exercise.
Yes,
our fourth exercise here. Just some chest flies. So after we exhausted our pressing movements, obviously you're not gonna get, I see too many people just doing too many presses. You lose so much efficiency that way because obviously you're not able to take the loads as high as you possibly can. Thus you're not getting the most muscle stimulation. So that's when you incorporate flies. You can still get the main primary activation across the fly, really activate that muscle in the chest without having to take the load so crazy high. And you reduce injury that way too. Here, chest flies. We're gonna do a working set with two drop sets. Just an intensity technique to add some volume. Really get the most out of training chest here as it's our last chest movement of this training session. Adding density to the set versus adding just more sets. Really becomes less efficient that way. So we're just gonna blast the chest and then move on from it. Get the most efficiency out of this training and then move on to shoulders. So
let's work. Yep. There you go, chest up, come on. Yes! Deep breath. keep breathing. Deep into the nose, out to the mouth. Yes, sir. Strong. Strong. Hey.
So we're on our third shoulder exercise here. What you just saw was some cable lateral raises. We just took some straight sets, just really focused on taxing that medial delt. Not too much volume, just because we're spreading out the volume across different exercises. So now we're doing some dumbbell front raises. Really just build out that, you know, anterior delt head, get that pop on stage, that roundness to the shoulder. Especially for me, that's one of the areas I got to bring up this year. And so we're working on it, so yeah. Alright, so we had partials as our finisher for shoulders. We did four shoulders exercises in total. Now we're gonna do three tricep movements. Three sets total on tries, so we'll do three exercises, one set each to failure. That's typically all the volume I do for my arms per week. I don't really train arms that much, despite how they look. But yeah, it's not one of my, it's one of the things that hasn't been a stubborn area for me to grow ever. I think I just trained them so well in the sense that my mind-muscle connection and the efficiency of how I train them is really what is like the secret, I guess, if you want to call it a secret. But yeah, so we got a easy bar tricep pushdowns, one of the staples I use. It's going to tear your top tip to failure. Hey.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10, one more.
All right, so we took that easy bar, tried to push down to failure, one set. Now we're using the same bar and just going underhand. Just make sure you really get that medial tricep head, because there are, that's why it's called a tricep, there's three heads. So when you do that easy bar push down, you're getting that outside head, underhands, inner head, overheads is that very most inner head. So yeah, same premise, two feeders, one set to failure.
That's you, come on.
Last tricep movement here. Got some overhead rope extensions. Again, hitting that innermost head of the tricep. Make sure we cover all our bases when we're doing this. And yeah, same thing. Two feeder sets, one set of failure.
Huh?
All right, so like I said, James is 17 weeks out of the Cal. It's a solid, solid session. As you saw, we got some really good numbers, really pushed it, but we're smart with it, right? We're not trying to get injured here. He's under 20 weeks, and I told him, you know, the last thing we want for the next 20 weeks is no injuries whatsoever. So we're gonna run through some drills, some posing. You gotta pose. So watch how I do it, watch how I take a pleasure in doing this with my athletes and they're really seeing them come to life. Thanks. Quarter turn to the right. Can you come down a little more in your oblique? Like crunch down this? There you go. Okay. Turn to the back. Coach, turn to the right. Looks dry, huh?
Yeah, I was gonna say. You sure you don't want to sit on stage sooner? Because, holy shit, put a tan on.
Nah, you're coming in undeniable. Good, relax, take a breather, and then we'll go through some mandatories. Front double. Just turn the knee out. There you go. I think you'll bring your toe a little bit. Side chest. like how full that looks.
Mm-hmm.
Can you see yourself?
A little bit, yeah.
Ab and thigh?
So for this one, which have you liked best so far?
Let's go through it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I like both. It's because you just got such a like.
Nuts.
You know how people like just look like rectangles when they do the front, and so they have to turn to the side to make it look like that. But when you turn to the side, it looks nasty as hell. But then it looks just great in the front too.
Yeah, I was just worried about how my legs, if it.
So let's try. Let's try putting the right leg forward.
Okay.
And then upper body square up to the front, and then crunching down. I like that better because it makes him look a lot more of the X frame versus just both feet on the line.
Yeah.
Okay. Now do the side with the right leg forward. Toe up.
Yeah, what's from that day?
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Good, relax, relax. Fuck. We'll get feedback on it before nationals. We'll ask the judges at the Cal what they think is a better pose on you.
Okay.
I say at the Cal we hit both, so like you, they say out of that you hit a couple seconds, three count in that front, and then switch over to that side, just transition it real quick and show them both.
Okay.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
But then after you
like this way, right?
Yeah. So you start off with like right foot front and just come over, boom. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, shift back. There you go. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000.
Mm-hmm.
In my shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
That is staying here. And I'm coming in and I'm only having my big toe on here and I'm flexing my quad just like I'm going to go kick a soccer ball. But that big toe is also in line with my shoulder. Come out.
Ah.
And then it just allows my knees. This one is completely horizontal.
So my kneecap is facing that mirror.
Mm-hmm. My kneecap is facing the front here. All my weight's on my right, flexing that quad. Boom, pushing pressure. There you go, pressure on that toe. And then coming up. Yeah, I think with more loosening of this,
yeah,
you'll be able to turn your hip without bringing your leg with it. Bring it a little closer and actually bend that leg.
I was telling her because she has so much more glute now, focus more on the interior delts, just to bring that more symmetry.
Good, relax. Back close to me. Good. Look great. I'm excited to really cut this down and see all the shit.
Just kidding. That is a joke. I'm not complaining.
I know you're not. I like your jokes.
We're all gonna die together.
Oh my god.
We'll get the same.
All three of you guys.
All right, there's like three swords. He's in there too.
I already practiced my clothes. It's gonna be okay, that's in the video.
It's okay, I got it.
The bloopers.